यस
आर यू देयर कुलदीप? या ओके, इट वाज शोइंग समबडी विल बी एग्जिट फ्रॉम द मीटिंग. या यू कैन सी माय स्क्रीन, इज इट? कैन हियर मी?
इट्स प्रेजेंटिंग सर.
या आई होप, या आई होप इट इज ओके. सो कैन यू सी दिस वन?
यस सर.
Yeah, anyway. Consider 741 operational amplifier circuit shown below, where VCC VEE is equal to 15 volt. Okay, so power supply, and R is equal to 2.2 kilo ohm. R. Okay, everything is 2.2 kilo ohm. Okay, VI is equal to 2 millivolt. 2 millivolt here. That is VI. So what is V naught with respect to the ground? That's what he is asking. Okay. Now look at here. This is inverting amplifier. You can apply all of your, all of the rules. Okay. V plus nearly equal to V minus. Can I say like this? Virtual ground concept. That means this is also at the zero potential, isn't it? This point. Can I say like this? Once this is at zero potential, look at here. These two resistances are parallel. Can you imagine? Rather than writing this resistance here, what I do is I'm going to draw that resistance from here to here. This is also ground, am I right? I'm going to rub out this part. Is that okay? From this point, one resistor to ground, am I right? From this point, one resistor R to ground. Is that okay? I'm going to remove this part. Are you getting my idea? Speak out, anyone. So because this is ground, this whole thing is ground here. So that's why. So let me rewrite the circuit like this, R and R, okay? So that, again, if you redraw the circuit, it would happen to be like this. Minus plus, okay? One resistor R here. This is grounded here. So these two are parallel. What is the effective resistance? R by 2? R by 2 in series with this R, okay? 3R by 2, total resistor in the feedback path is actually 3R by 2. 3R by 2. This is V naught. This is VI. That's equal to 2 millivolt. This is also R. Okay. What is this one? V naught by VI. That's equal to minus RF by R1. Minus RF by R1. This is RF. This is R1. That's equal to minus 3 by 2 R divided by R. Okay. So that's equal to V naught is equal to minus 3 by 2 into VI. VI is nothing but 2 millivolt. That's equal to minus 3 millivolt. Am I right? Can I write like this? Speak out. Minus 3 millivolt. Yes. Here's the key answer. So are you grabbing this idea? Okay. Speak out. Any question?
Yes.
Yeah. Now, I mean, again, this is also just question only. Yeah, I think this is also just question. I mean, it's a way of seeing the circuit. Okay. So again, you need effective resistance in the feedback path, isn't it? Now, once you start applying your concept, virtual ground, if this is ground, this is also ground, isn't it? So this concept will help you to improve the circuit. Am I right? If this is ground, this is ground, these two are parallel. This is the next idea. Okay. So quickly you will get that idea. Okay. So next one. The figure on the right shows the current and voltage characteristic of a diode over a range of voltage and current where it is safe to operate the diode. Okay, he mentioned current, everything here. Okay, so up to minus 40 milliamps. So again, so current can flow here. Okay, up to minus 10, or again you can go, voltage can be anything. Okay, again, voltage can be minus 10, minus 15, whatever. Okay, so this is reverse bias, this is forward bias. You can see this one, am I right? So this is forward bias, this is reverse bias. Okay, yeah. Now look at the circuit here. The question is, when this diode is used in the circuit on the extreme right, okay, here, the approximate current in milliamps through the diode will be, okay, what is the current through the diode? Okay, now again, you are in which region of this what you call characteristic, that you need to point out. Okay, now when you see this, look at here, this is positive. Positive is connected to N terminal, negative is connected to P terminal. This is reverse bias. obviously you should be somewhere in this region, isn't it? In this region, where are you? You have 15 volt, am I right? You have 15 volt, 200 what you call ohm here. Suppose again, you are around this region actually. Are you getting my point? You are in this region. Is that okay? If voltage is around what you call, this is reverse voltage actually, and it is beyond minus 10 actually, somewhere in this region, okay? So because of that, this is reverse bias in this region. Again, I have pasted some what you call circuit from Boyle state here, okay? So again, actually this is Zener diode characteristic, okay? So this is also Zener diode characteristic. Usually ordinary diode will not be used in this region, am I right? But he gave one diode where he is saying it can be used in this region also. He gave characteristic like that, okay? Usually in this region it will burn out. Our ordinary diode will burn out actually, okay? You know that one. Now look at here. So in this region, okay, this is what we call, I don't remember, reverse breakdown region, isn't it? We say like that, okay? Breakdown region. But Zener diode can carry much current actually, okay? So Zener diode will be designed like this. Assume that this given diode is Zener diode. If it is in this region, look at here, it will act like a battery. Diode will act like a battery, just like here it act like a battery of 0.7 volt, am I right? In the forward bias region. In the reverse bias region also, it will act like a battery of what you call potential VZ. So can you see here? Yeah. So now I'm going to redraw the circuit. Okay, I'm going to redraw the circuit. 15 volt, 200. So now this diode, look at here, diode, this is positive, this is negative, okay? So that's why diode will act like battery of potential difference VZ. What is VZ here? Can you just see? VZ is minus 10 volt actually. So 10 volt here, is that okay? So that's why this is 15 volt. Diode will act like a battery of 10 volt. Okay, the output resistance is or some resistance 600 ohm. This is 200 ohm. Now everything else is Kirchhoff voltage law. Okay, what is the current through the diode? Okay, you need current through the diode. Now let me assume. Suppose this is a total current, okay, because this battery is quite dominant than this battery, isn't it? This is total current. Let me write, this is I1, this is I2. Is that okay? One equation is at this node, I is equal to I1 plus I2. Is that recording? Yeah. I is equal to I1 plus I2, okay? Other equation is, I think you can apply some Kirchhoff voltage law or something. Speak out to this circuit and to this circuit.
So we can consider the bigger circuit.
This one?
The bigger loop. Like 15 volt, 200 ohms.
But you need this I1 actually. Yeah, anyway, you do it in your way. Let me do it in my way. 15, okay. I'll not write volt. Minus 200 I. Okay, so here this is higher potential to lower potential, minus 10 volt, okay, 15 volt minus 10 volt is equal to 0, okay, in this circuit. So let me 15 minus 10, 5 minus 200 into I is equal to 0, 200 ohm, okay. So this is one equation. Other equation I have here. The third equation, let me apply Y. So 10 volt here, let me apply Kirchhoff voltage law to this circuit, okay? If I apply Kirchhoff voltage law to that circuit, look at here, this is 10 volt increasing, okay? Here minus 600 I2 is equal to 0. Check this out. So 10 volt, okay? So 600 minus 600, because I2 will flow here, am I right? Along the direction of current, you have negative sign. So this is another equation. Okay, what I need is I need I1. So from this one, I'll get I2. Am I right? What is I2? 10 by 600, 1 by 60, Either okay. I2 is equal to 1 by 60 ampere actually. I am not writing ampere, okay? It is ampere. It is in ampere. So then what I need is, I have I here. I from this circuit. Am I right? What is this I? I is equal to, speak out, 5 divided by 200. Am I right? What is this one? How much?
4 milliamps.
40? 40?
Yes.
Is that okay? 1 by 40. 1 by 40. Then I1 is that what I need. Am I right? What he's asking? What is the current through the diode? That is I1 actually here in my circuit. This is I1. This was the place of diode. I hope you got the idea. Okay. So that I1 is equal to I minus I2. That's equal. Am I right? 1 by 40?
Yes, sir.
1 by 40 minus 1 by 60. Quickly check this out. Yeah. So check this out. What is the value?
Eight point three milliamps.
Yeah, that's correct. 8.3 milliamps. This is actually in amps. Okay, let's convert it into milliamps. That's correct. Okay, option B, key answer here.
Sir,
how
do we know that the diode is in this region only, minus 10?
No. You have 15 volt and you have very less resistance here. Okay.
The current may have been much more through it. Without calculating, how do we
know? No, again, if you calculate, okay, if current is happened to be more than minus 40 volt or more than 40 milliamps, then you can say this will burn out or something.
Okay.
But again, none of the options are more than what you call magnitude more than 40 milliamps, as well as you also got the what you call 8.3 milliamps, isn't it? Is that okay? Speak out.
Yes.
And you have this one 15 volt, which is more than this VZ, am I right? So that's what we say, am I right? Potential difference across the diode, if that is more than VZ, again, it will act like a battery of VZ, isn't it? Is that okay? But be careful, this is positive terminal, this is negative terminal, okay? So in this case, this is negative terminal, look at here, when it is forward bias, this will be positive terminal, so terminal. So P region will be, so positive terminal, N region will be negative terminal in case of forward bias, okay? It will act like a battery like this, okay? In this region, it is quite reverse, okay? Be careful while dealing with this one. Don't make this battery reverse, okay? Speak out. Is that okay? Speak out.
Yes.
But he could have mentioned it is Zener diode, isn't it?
The diode structure, N side is upside, right?
No, so this is P, this is N, this is P, this is P, this is N, am I right? So when it is forward bias, it will act like a battery. That battery contains P region positive, N region negative. When it is forward bias, forward characteristic. Again, it is for Zener diode, the same hold for any diode, okay? When it is reverse bias, okay, look at here. Again, just observe this circuit, okay? When it is reverse bias, this is equivalent to battery, this kind of battery, okay? When it is forward bias, look at here, let me draw reverse, in a reverse way. This is equivalent to, this is negative. Is that okay? This is positive. Is that okay? And it will be 0.7 volt or something. So depending on the, whether it's germanium or silicon, is that okay? So this is the difference, okay? This is in this reverse breakdown region. This is in the forward bias region, okay? Can you remember this part? Small difference here, okay? That's very important. Yeah, any more questions? Now, again, one more circuit here. Consider the following circuit where input is given like this, okay? Input is, let me draw the input, okay? So 10 here, 5 here. minus 5 minus 10 here, okay? 5, 10 volt, okay? V in. So minus 5 minus 10 volt, okay? So your input voltage will vary like this, isn't it? Is that okay? Now look at here, which of the graph gives V out? V out is the potential at this point, or potential difference at this point to ground, okay? So can you see this one? This is one point, this is another point, okay? V out is the potential difference between these two point. Is it possible to choose any other color? Is that okay? So these are the two points actually. Is that okay? So that you are finding potential difference. Okay. So now look at here. When you have a positive cycle, okay, up to 5 volt. Okay. You can say this is V. This is V in. Let me call this one as V in. This is 0 volt. Isn't it? I hope I talked about this one, am I right? So since this is 0 volt, this will be V in. So that potential difference will be V in. Is that okay? So now if this V in, look at here, there is no current flowing. If current is not flowing, this V in is same as this potential is same as this potential. If current is not flowing through any resistor, potential difference is 0. That's why this potential is same as this potential. Can I say like this? This is V in. Is that okay? For a time sake, okay? So when V in increases from 0 to 5 volt, okay? When V in increases from 0 to 5 volt, look at here. This diode is what you call reverse bias. It will act like a open. Is that okay? When V in is between 0 to 5 volt, okay? Your circuit will be like this. Okay? 1k. So this is a diode place, but it is 5 volt. This is the diode place. Is that okay? So when V in is between 0 to plus 5 volt, okay? So your circuit will be like this. Now what is the potential here? Potential at this point. Now no current flows here. Potential at this point is same as V in, am I right? So this is 0. Is that okay? So that's why 0 to 5 volt, look at here, let me draw the output voltage here itself, okay, in the red line. 0 to 5 volt, it will follow the what you call input, okay? So when V in is greater than 5 volt, or V in is 5 volt to, V in is 5 volt to 10 volt, is that okay? So in that region, what will happen is, look at here, if V in is greater than 5 volt, this diode will be forward bias, am I right? Are you understand? If this potential is less than this potential, it will be reverse bias. Can you see this one? This is PN. P here and here. So if V in this, again, potential at P is more than potential at N, it will be forward bias. He has taken ideal diode here, okay? Not 0.7 volt like that, okay? Ideal diode here. When it is forward bias, look at here, your circuit should look like this. Okay, so it is shorted to plus 5 volt. This was the place of diode, okay? But it is shorted now. And you need potential between this one and ground. Here also you need potential, sir? Between, yes.
Sir, why it is shorted?
Forward bias. When this point potential is greater than 5 volt, so you, sir, again find the
part like a battery.
No. Again, it is ideal diode. That's what I'm saying. If they are not mentioning that it is silicon diode with forward the voltage 0.7 volt, take it as ideal diode.
Okay.
Otherwise, they will mention specifically. Take forward voltage as 0.7 volt. Okay.
Okay.
Is that okay? So now, when this potential is great, again, potential difference across the diode does matter. Am I right? When it is, whether it is forward bias or reverse bias, you have connected plus 5 volt here, isn't it? So that's why. What will happen? Diode will be short, okay? So then what is output voltage now? Whatever the input voltage, that output is directly connected to 5 volt here, isn't it? When V in varies like this, In that situation, output will saturate at 5 volt. Is that okay? Speak out. And then again, it will follow the input when Vin is 0 to 5 volt. Okay. When you have negative input here, okay, when this is negative potential compared to this one, this will, it will act like a open. Am I right? When it act like a open, it will follow the input again, just like what you call in this case. Is that okay? Just like in this case. So again, it will follow the input. So this red colored line is my output. Can you grab this one? So that is option B. Is that okay? So can you analyze again? So take the circuit and analyze again. Speak out. Zero here, 0 to 5, 5 to 0. It will follow. And reverse bias, it will again, reverse bias means this is negative, am I right? So this is negative with respect, this is positive, am I right? Speak out. In this region, when Vin is 5 volt to 10 volt, so this will be more positive than this one. That's why it is forward bias, isn't it?
But we have 5 volt, right?
More positive means Vin is 5 to 10 volt. When Vin is more than 5 volt, this is more positive than this one, am I right? Then it is forward bias. Speak up. Can you analyze like this? Yeah, any question quickly? Speak up.
Sir?
Yeah.
But in this, if we take this pattern to be non-ideal, then also it will saturate at 5.7 only, right?
No. Then what will happen? Yeah, 5.7, because one more battery will come in place of diode. Hmm. Yeah, that's correct. That's correct. Okay.
So but it will not increase beyond 5.7.
No. It will not increase beyond 5.7. Okay? Okay. So just think, when diode is forward bias, reverse bias. Hmm. Again. So in case of reverse bias, or what you call replace diode. Again, look at here. When Vin is negative. What is the equivalent circuit? Resistor. So this is the point. This is the diode. Diode will act like reverse bias because this is 5 volt. This is negative. Am I right? So this is a place of diode. And you are finding output voltage between these two. Am I right?
Yeah.
Is that okay? Now this will follow the input again. Is that okay? Vin. Is that okay? This is the argument. So try to argue like that. Okay. So do it again. Problem. Okay. Yeah. What is the voltage at the output of the following operational amplifier circuit? Okay. So in many cases, they may mention some current source. Okay. Usually we don't use any current source. Okay. We take what you call voltage source only. We convert that one into current source like that. Isn't it? So again, current source is something which supplies a constant current, whatever it happens. Okay. So that's why he said that, what is the output voltage of operation amplifier? Okay. This is a current source, 1 nanoamps, whatever he has written. It's a current source here. It will maintain 1 nanoamps, whatever the situation here is. Okay. It will maintain 1 nanoamps current into this one. Are you getting my point? Speak up. That's a current source, because there are many other questions. So in just exam only, where he gives current source, actually not voltage source. Is that okay? So now again, you should be happy with this one, because since he has already given current here. Okay, so that means, you know, current through this one, current through op amp is almost zero. That's why this 1 nanoamp should flow here. Pick out. Let me write this one as v01 output of first op amp. Okay, this first op amp, second op amp. Is that okay? Speak out. Now again, according to what you call our virtual ground concept, this should be 0 volt, this should be v01. Now can you apply Kirchhoff voltage law here, or what you call, how to write? Speak out. This one minus this one, am I right? Yeah. How do you apply Kirchhoff voltage law? Or again, higher potential to lower potential, am I right? Current flow from zero higher potential to, yeah, 0 minus V01 divided by, so 10k is equal to 1 nanoamps. isn't it? Can I write like this?
Yes.
So that's why V01 is equal to minus 1 nanoamps multiplied with 10 kilo ohm. So that is, I think, minus 10 microvolt. Okay. Kilo nano. Nano multiplied with kilo is micro. Okay. So now this is minus 10 microvolt. That is the potential here. Okay. Now what is, again, this is a what you call non-inverting amplifier now. Okay. Not a big deal. It's a non-inverting amplifier. But the gain, V out divided by V in is this one. Okay. Minus 10 microvolt. Okay. That's equal to 1 plus RF by R1. That 1 plus RF by R1 is 1 plus 99 divided by 1. Am I right? 99K divided by 1K. KK will get cancelled. This is equal to 100 actually. Okay. That's why V out is equal to, speak out, minus 10 microvolt multiplied with 100, which is a gain. That's equal to 1000 microvolt minus 1 millivolt. Is that okay? Speak out.
Yes, sir.
There is no confusion here, am I right? Yeah, this is the answer key. Is that okay? Speak out. Quite a straightforward question.
Sir, but okay. Answer is in plus.
No, whatever. There is no other option, isn't it? I mean, okay. If one is plus 1 millivolt, other one is minus 1 millivolt, you should have, you should be quite careful, am I right? Speak out. Obviously, if current flows like this, this should be negative only. Okay, if this is negative, this output will follow the input because this is a non-inverting amplifier. Okay, it should be negative only. You can see this one. Is that okay? Speak up. So shall I close? V01 cannot be positive because current is flowing from 0 volt to some again, current can flow from high voltage to low, high potential to low potential. Am I right about this one? Isn't it? That's why this should be lower than this one. If this is zero, this should be negative. Okay, whatever, there is no confusion here. Okay, if one of the option is plus 1 millivolt, other option is minus 1 millivolt, you should be what you call worried about that one, isn't it? But there is no confusion like that. That's why you can choose that one. Is that okay? Speak out. Magnitude of the output voltage. So shall I move on?
Yes.
Yes. Yeah. I hope this one you can directly do, isn't it? During forward bias, one will be what you call, again, so during positive cycle, one will be forward bias after 0.7 volt, other will be reverse bias, remove that one, but forward bias will act like 0.7 volt. That's why output will saturate to 0.7 volt. Am I right? That's why circuit will, again, output will be like this. Can you quickly guess?
Yes.
I think we did this kind of problem, isn't it? Or you just go through Boyle state book, okay?
So this is a rectifier.
No. It's not rectifier. Rectifier means it should allow. It's not allowing any of this. This 0.7 is very low, actually, compared to here. It is 3.5 volt. Am I right? This 0.7 is very low. It is cutting off both positive as well as negative half cycle. Okay, it's not rectifier. Okay, I hope you, again, during positive half cycle, what will happen? This is positive, this is negative. That means this will be forward bias. Okay, if it is forward bias, it will act like a battery like this. Am I right? This one. Okay, so during reverse bias, this will be forward bias. It will act like a battery like this, actually. That's how output will follow this battery, actually. Okay, whatever happens in the input. Okay, I hope we dealt with this kind of thing earlier. Okay, yeah. Analyze the ideal op amp circuit in the figure. Which one of the following statement is true about the output voltage V out when C terminal is connected to point A, then to point B? Okay, C is once connected to point A, then connected to point B. Okay, I hope you can see this one. Now, when C is connected to B, I hope you should have no problem, am I right? When C is connected to point B, can I draw the circuit? This is C, okay? When C is connected to B, means this C is grounded. So you have what you call inverting amplifier. This is Vin, am I right? So now, so this is this has open end here, okay? Is that okay? This has open end. Whatever, again, Vin will be sent here, okay? Even though some resistance or something is here, you don't have to worry, isn't it? Pick up. So, but again, this Vin will be sent here, okay? This will be Vin. Can I see the circuit like this? Okay, when C connected to B, okay, when C connected to B, this would happen. Am I right? So R here, R here. So what is output? Minus RF by R1. This is RF, this is R1, okay? Into V in, isn't it? V out will be equal to minus V in. Okay, when C connected to B, when C connected to B, look at the option. V out will be minus V in. Okay. When C connected to B, V out will be minus V in. This is a possibility. Okay. What is the other possibility? V out will be equal to minus V in when C connected to B. These are the two possibility. Other two you can rule out. Why? When C connected to B, he is saying V out is equal to V in. Okay. V out is equal to V in when C connected to B. Okay. So other two you can rule out. But look at here. You have to check out other option also. What is that one? When C is connected to A. When C is connected to A, what is the circuit? Just see the circuit properly. When C connected to A. Now this is quite tricky step now. I think I have discussed some more technique during classes. I too forgot actually. V out. Okay. So this is V in, am I right? So now when C connected to A, C is also connected to V in only, am I right? When C connected to A, that means C is V in only. So can I write V in here? That means both are V in here. Is that okay? This is R here, R here. Now the circuit is like this. Pick out. Now how do you analyze the circuit? Speak up.
It becomes a voltage follower.
No. V plus here, V minus here. V plus nearly equal to V minus. You should apply that one actually.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It will become V minus will also become V in. So V naught will become V in.
V minus is why V minus is V in?
Sir, V plus is equal to V minus, no?
If it is, yeah, if V minus is equal to V in, why output will be equal to V in? You have one more resistor here.
Sir, this thing is shorted, no? V in and this is V in.
It will be like short, right?
Which one?
Is V input and V input, it will be like short.
This one and this one? Not short. That means there is no current actually. If there is no current, there should be no potential difference. Then V out is same as this one. That's correct argument. Yes. But you better to work out this one. Just like we do, we find V plus, we find V minus,
no, sir, we equate that.
No. This is an inverting amplifier. You can say V plus nearly equal to V minus. No doubt. This is always true. Okay. What I'm saying is find V minus, okay, equate that one to V plus, that is V in. I think you will get V naught is equal to V in only. Are you getting a point? We did this kind of circuit. Do you remember we applied Kirchhoff voltage law like this?
Yes, sir.
V naught, then we worked out something. We found this V minus. Yeah. Can you quickly do that one? Anyway, that
V
idea.
V minus is V in, no? It will current flowing will be zero in that line.
Yeah, again V minus will be equal to V plus is equal to V in.
Yeah.
But to connect that one to V naught, you need to first apply Kirchhoff voltage law to this one, am I right?
Sir,
if you say V minus equal to V in.
Yeah, that is what I'm saying. By applying Kirchhoff law only, the current in the circuit is zero.
Yeah, that
that's
you can
where becomes the voltage
that's correct. That's correct argument. Okay. Or you do like this. Okay. So there is no I don't think it will consume much time. R here, V minus here. Am I right? This circuit, okay? I have drawn this one. V naught here, V in here. Apply Kirchhoff voltage law and Ohm's law, whatever. Find V minus and equate that one to V plus. That is equal to V in. And you can find out V naught. Okay. Our other argument, as he told, what is the other argument? V minus equal to V in. Am I right? Just like similar to virtual ground concept. Whatever the potential happens here, the same potential will be followed here because of this one. Okay. So now if this is V in, so there is no current through this one, am I right? If this is also V in, this is also V in. If these two are, if there is no current here, there will be no current in the feedback path also. If there is no current, then this potential equal to this potential. Is that it? That is the idea. That's correct. V naught will be equal to V in. Okay. When C connected to VA, okay, V out will be equal to V in. That is, I think, option A, am I right? Because C connected to A, V out cannot be minus V in, it's equal to V in, that's equal to option A. Is that okay? Speak out. Yeah, so analyze that one properly. I think you can do. Now, this circuit, I think I gave the, what you call, formula, okay? Instrumentation amplifier, okay? So it contains three op-amp. He has given resistance, all of them are equal actually, V1, V2 here. Op-amp are ideal and all resistors are equal, value R. The gain is defined as output voltage divided by difference of the input, okay? V0 divided by V1 minus V2, okay? This is the gain. Now, I2 don't remember, okay? You have to follow my earlier classes. I just copied from Wikipedia here, okay? So this is the instrumentation amplifier, this is the gain. Is that okay? Now this gain is equal to, look at here, 1 plus 2R1 divided by R gain, okay? So this R1 is nothing but this one. Can you see? This is R1 actually. So this is a feedback resistor. Can you see this one? So this is a feedback resistor output, okay? So this is equal to R1. This is equal to R1. Can you see this one? This is R gain. Okay. So circuit is slightly modified. I hope you can handle that one. Okay. So, and 2R1 by R gain, R3 by R2. What is R3? What is R2? This is R3. This is R2. Everything is R here. Okay. So that's why this gain is equal to, look at here, 1 plus 2R1 by R gain, okay, multiplied with, speak out, R3 by R2. So that's equal to 1 plus 2R1, that means 2 into R divided by R, everything is R here, into what you call R by R. 3. Direct formula, okay. Quite lengthy to what you call derive out here. Okay. Can you remember this one? Speak up.
Yes, sir. But if the circuit comes with that modification?
No, modification is they may modify the resistor. Okay. But they will not modify this one because it's a very famous circuit, instrumentation amplifier.
Okay.
So it has got a lot of application. That's why, again, they may what you call change these things, but this formula contains R1, R2, R3 here, isn't it? So they will make this one as variable actually, so that you can control the gain. They may change the register, but in this case he has given all registers same. Okay, yeah, so check that out. Yeah, one more diode problem. Consider a circuit shown in the figure where R1 is equal to 2.07 kilo ohm, R2 is equal to 1.93 kilo ohm. Current source I delivers 10 milliamp. What does this current source does? Whatever it happens, it will deliver 10 milliamp here. Is that okay? I'll call that current as I. Okay. Now that current will be divided here. I better to write the, what you call, equivalent circuit, am I right? You have 10 milliamps here. You have one resistor here. Or to apply Kirchhoff voltage law, better to short these two. Now diode will act like a 0.7 volt battery, okay? Because 10 milliamps is flowing means obviously it is forward bias, okay? Yeah. So now in case of forward bias, P, pick out which one negative, which one positive. So in case of forward bias, again, how to redraw the circuit quickly. So P is negative. I think I told here.
P is positive.
P will be negative. Look at here. Sorry. So P, yeah.
Sir,
so
P is positive.
P is positive. Okay, here it is ulta. Yeah.
Sir.
Yeah, that's correct. P is positive. So positive here, negative here, positive here, negative here. 0.7 volt battery. With one more resistance R2. This is grounded, whatever. What is the potential at A? That is he's asking. Okay. But to find potential at A, I need to find this current. Look at here. This is current I is equal to 10 milliamps. Okay. Let me say this current is I1. This current is I2. I need this I2. Okay. Because I know this resistance. This is, can I say R2 here? R1 here? If I know what is the I2, okay, I can I2 R2 is nothing but potential difference. You know this is zero potential. You can find the potential at this point, okay? You should know I2 here. Now I know I1 plus I2. I1 plus I2 is equal to 10 milliamps, okay? This one equation. Other equation, apply Kirchhoff voltage law here. Pick out, okay? If you apply Kirchhoff voltage law, what will happen? I1 R1, am I right? Opposite to the current direction. This is positive to negative, decrease in minus 0.7 volt. Along the direction of current decreases, minus I2 R2 equal to zero. What do you need? Speak out. I2, am I right?
Yes, sir.
You need I2. What you can do, you can solve it for I1, you can substitute, or you can solve it for I1. What is I1? 10 milliamps minus I2. Substitute this I1 here, you will get I2. Am I right? 10 milliamps minus I2 R1 minus 0.7 volt. Okay, minus I2 R2 is equal to 0. I need I2. 10 milliamps into R1. What is R1? 2.07 kilo, am I right? 10 milliamps into 2.07 kilo, okay? Kilo ohm, minus I2 R1, okay? Minus 0.7 volt, minus I2 R2, or you do it in your way, okay? This may be lengthy, whatever I did here. You try in your way, okay? I think what is this one? 20.7, isn't it? Milli into kilo, minus 0.7 volt here, okay? Minus I2 into R1 plus R2. I2 is equal to 20 divided by R1 plus R2. What the value? Pick out. R1 plus R2.
4, sir.
4?
4.
20 divided by R1 plus R2 is nothing but 5 kilo ohm. That's equal to 4 milliamps. Is that okay? But I need the potential at this point. Again, this is I2. I got I2 now. That's equal to 4 milliamps. Okay? So I2 into R2 is nothing but V, so can I say V at A? This is V at A. V at zero, okay? Or V at ground, okay? V at A minus V at ground is equal to current I2 into R2. Okay? That's why V at A, V at ground equal to 0. That's equal to I2 into R2. I2 is nothing but 4 milliamps multiplied with 1.93 5. This is 4, am I right?
Yes, sir.
5 milliamps. Be careful. That may be option like that, okay? This is 5. 5 milliamps, this is equal to, I think, just check that out. What would happen? 1.9 here by
9.85.
Okay. I hope you can deal with this one. Again, current source, if they give current source, don't get panic, okay? It will deliver a constant current. Just like ideal voltage source, it will deliver a what you call constant potential difference, isn't it? Always. Like that. In the generalized operational amplifier circuit shown on the right, op amp has a very high input impedance, okay? Z is greater than 50 mega ohm. Okay, this Z is greater than 50 mega ohm. Open gain is what you call AOL, am I right? We write AOL is equal to 1000 for a frequency range under consideration. Assuming that op amp draws negligible current, the voltage ratio V2 by V1. Yeah, why he has given like this? It's just a inverting amplifier, am I right? Check this out. Isn't it? Can I take this one as 0 volt in the whole circuit? I'll take this one as a reference, 0 volt. Okay, that's your choice always in any electrical circuit. Speak out. I don't think these other parameters are useful. Okay, AOL is also again V2 by V1. That's equal to what you call closed loop gain. Am I right? Closed loop gain is minus 500k divided by 5k. Isn't it? Minus 100. But you don't have option. Now what he's expecting? Can you tell me? He's expecting exact answer. This was approximated answer. Minus RF by R1. This was approximated. Do you remember? Speak out, anyone.
Yes.
Can you hear me? This was approximated actually, but here again, this approximation, when AOL is infinity, when V plus nearly equal to V minus, we write V plus nearly equal to V minus when AOL is infinity, but he has given AOL finite, 1000 is not much big actually. Is that clear?
Okay.
Now, can you find this ACL in terms of something which contain AOL and everything, some ratio? Can you work out that one? So we did this one in class. Look at here. That also required. I think I told that one during the class that you may need to remember this one because there are some questions where they are expecting the exact what you call gain. Okay. But it will not be too much far. I hope it will be around 90. What you guess, isn't it? 190, it is too far, am I right? 90 or 80, it may happen to be between 90 and 80 here, okay? Maybe 90 is the answer, but work out that, look at here, what they are expecting? They are expecting that exact formula. Anybody remember? Exact formula of closed loop gain of inverting amplifier. I think, wait a second.
AOL tends to infinity, we put that as zero, and then we take
LCM. R1 divided by R1 plus RF. Minus 1 whole divided by 1 by AOL plus R1 divided by
R1 plus RF.
Isn't it? This is your closed loop gain. Can you substitute quickly? What is R1 divided by R1 plus RF? 5 divided by 505, am I right? 5 divided by 505. minus 1 divided by 1 by AL 1 by 1000 plus 5 divided by 505. Can you grab me this answer? Negative, obviously. Speak up. Yeah, you can use calculator in just a second. Yeah, anyone have a calculator? 490. No. Should be negative, am I right?
Done something wrong. Minus.
This is 0.99, okay? Whole divided by. Zero point zero zero one plus 0.00999. 0.01 actually. 0.99 divided by 0.01. Yeah, it's nearly equal to 100 only. Isn't it? 99. I got some 99 here.
Yes, sir.
Not even 90. Check this out.
I got 90.8. Minus of.
Now, where I did the mistake? Where I did the mistake here? R1 divided by.
Sir, I'm getting 90.8.
Yeah, 0.99. Okay. Is this correct? Minus 0.99? Numerator? Point 0001. 505. 0.0099. Yeah, I think I've taken only 19. That does matter sometimes. 0.001 plus 0.0099. Look at here. I have taken minus 0.99 divided by 0.1, okay? What I got? Minus 99, isn't it? Sorry, 0. I think one more zero should be there. Check this out. 0109, okay? Figure out. What I have taken? 0.01. I have taken 0.01. What you get? 99. Isn't it? 0.99 minus 0.99 divided by 0.0109. This is 90.8. Look at here. So that's why while dividing and multiplying, that fraction does matter. I think I told this one, am I right? Somewhere while discussing, while doing some approximation, I told that one. While adding or subtracting, you can neglect something, okay? But while dividing and multiplying, those are very important. Okay. Be careful. That's correct. Nearly 90, minus 90. That's correct answer. Okay. Yeah.